Hey, MTSU. My name is Joanna, and welcome to Health Fit, MT10's healthy lifestyle show. As the concluding episode of season one, we have a lot planned to celebrate. We'll start with our exercise segment, in which I'll introduce you to a different and refreshing form of cardio, dance fitness. Later, we'll make a smoothie so delicious you almost won't believe it's good for you. And lastly, we'll get a chance to explore another more chilling version of cardio with our guest speaker. You will certainly feel inspired to spike your ambition in discovering your healthy fit self. Now, let's move. Week, I lead students at MTSU in my Dance Fit cardio class, where we move to choreographed pieces, working our entire bodies while releasing the accumulated stress from the day. Tonight, I'm bringing my class to you. With the help of course, my guest dancers, Bing and Colleen, I'm going to lead you through a miniature Dance Fit class that you can participate in wherever you are. No weights, mats, or other equipment is needed. Tonight is simply about moving. I do recommend water nearby and towel as well. So, let's dance! Go ahead and start with two jumps on each leg. Good. Right to left two. Nice. Keep it up. Ready, singles. Go one. Right, left. Good. Keep going. Nice. Let's take it to the right. Step two. Go left, two. Right, two. Left, two. Good. Keep going. Right, two. Left, two. Again, two. All right, arm circles to the right. Good. And switch. Again, right, and left, keep going. Again, one more time. Let's jump again. Here we go, two and two. Ready, single. Good. All right, we're about to take it to the right again. Five, six, and right, two, left, two, again. Ready, elbow. One, two, punch, and step. Again. One more time. Good. Let's kick. Right, left, down, down, down. Again. And down. Keep jumping. Good. We're about to do the exact same thing. Ready, step right, two, left, two. Good. Arms and hips. Ready to take it forward. Here we go. Five, six, 5, 6, 7, go forward. And up. Go back. Up again. Ready, take it to the right. Here we go, right. Up. Good, again. Woo! Nice. Moving along. Set. Left. Good. Start right here, nice and slow. That big. All right, here we go. High knees, up, up. Faster. Let's squat. 3, up. 1, 2, 3, up. Good. Again, keep going. Get low. Nice. Let's take a step forward. Step. 2, 3. Take it back. Good. Go to right, left. Right, left. Good. Right, left. Two more. Let's jump forward. Back it up. 1, 2. Good. Again. Back it up. Again. Jump forward. Back it up. Nice. One more time. Back it up. In. 2, 2, 1, 1. 2, 1, 1, go 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, from the top, step forward, good, take it back, good, go right, 1, 2, 3, good, 4, going, last 2, let's jump forward. Back it up. 1, 2, 3. Again. Back it up. One more time. All right, I lied. One more time. Knees. Here we go. Bring 1, 1, 2, 1, 1 and 2. And go 2, 1, 1, 2, 1, 1. Woo! Nice. All right, just kind of jog in place. Relax. This is our third song. Woo! Here we go. Right side and back. Right. Side, back, left, back, up, workout, girls. Hope you all enjoyed it as much as we did. Nice job. Yeah. Now don't go anywhere. A rejuvenating post-workout smoothie is coming up next. Whew, thanks.
Miss Lee, this is Agent Williams from the tax office. Our records show an unpaid balance on your account. If you don't pay by end of day, you'll be facing jail time. Well, the fastest way to fix this is with a prepaid debit card. Can you go get one now? Yes, and we want to clear this up. If you just buy that prepaid card, put $400 on it, then call me back and read the numbers to me.
The moment they ask for a prepaid card is the moment you know something's wrong. Think before you send money. Learn more at scamawareness.org.
As a mother, you don't want to have to worry about this bill is coming, but then she needs this chemo. That's a decision you shouldn't have to make.
At St. Jude, a family never sees a bill at all, not one bill. It's like the world has been lifted off of your shoulders.
The treatment doesn't get any better than what you receive at St. Jude. It saved my life. It saved my daughter's life. It saved our family.
Welcome back. Here we are in the HealthFit kitchen where we awaken our taste buds and fuel our bodies. This week's smoothie is cinnamon apple. Think of it as a healthier version of apple pie. So our ingredients start off with our fruit. We have a small cut of banana accompanied by half of a gala apple. You will notice that I have not peeled the apple because actually most of the nutrients and fiber is in the skin of the apple. Next up is our almond milk as usual. Feel free to substitute it for any kind of other milk that you may like, such as cow's milk, cashew milk, and really anything else. Next up, we have vanilla protein powder, one scoop. Here is another dairy product, Greek plain yogurt, half a cup. A little bit of oats for texture, I'd say about a quarter of a cup. And 2 teaspoons of stevia, a little bit of cinnamon, and a little bit of vanilla. So let's get started. Add our fruit in. Next up, milk. Oh, this is gonna be so good. Yogurt. Also, the yogurt actually adds a nice thickness to your smoothie. I personally like that. If you don't, you can opt out for less yogurt. It's whatever you want, and it's all about your personal preference. Stevia for more sweetness. Gotta keep those cravings away. Cinnamon, I like cinnamon, so I'm gonna add a little extra. And let's go for a couple of drops of vanilla, but we'll see how I'll do. Oh, good. Let's mix it up. And how did we do? Lumpy. That's okay. Just goes to show we have plenty of fiber in there. You can feel free to add a little dash of cinnamon on top so it's really pretty. And let's try it. Oh my God, so good. So, next we are super excited to celebrate our first season of HealthFit by premiering a special short film reminiscing on all the work we did. Thank you. MTSU. My name is Joanna, and I'm so excited. That's not right. My teleprompter is completely off. Keep it up. Thank you, Colleen, for demonstrating and helping us out today. Jesus. I was supposed to help you. I was supposed to be like, thank you, God. Much for helping us.
I don't know if...
That's not right. And I don't have my words.
That's awkward.
Cow's milk, soy milk.
Let's restart that, sorry. I messed up.
Go for about 1 or 2 drops.
Maybe that was a little too much, we'll see.
A small cut up banana accompanied by a half.
We gotta restart that, sorry.
You didn't like my wink. I knew it.
God, this is gonna take forever. Go ahead and tell us a little bit about yourself, how you relate to the fitness world.
Well,
sorry. Could you please tell me more about yourself and really in relation to your bodybuilding competition?
All right, we gotta stop, sorry.
Hey, look at him. Wow.
Thank you for inviting me.
So,
let's hold. We're gonna restart that.
All right, we're restarting that.
The number one advice I give to people just starting out running or on their fitness endeavor is to...
Oh, look at tricep. Now, let's move. Well, better cut now then. Later.
Your seat cushion can be used to grant wishes.
Who said that? Hello?
Really can, you know.
You talking to me?
Sure am. Because the airline miles you earn and donate to Make-A-Wish can help send thousands of kids on their wish trips. So donate to Make-A-Wish today.
You really should, you know. You really should.
And give wishes wings, because wishes work wonders.
Hey there! Tonight's special guest is an MTSU senior who has a dedicated passion for all things ice hockey. Growing up as an athlete in the greater Philadelphia area, he was surrounded by the die-hard hockey fans of the East Coast and embraced the enthusiastic sport. He continues to live out his hockey lifestyle here in Tennessee today, making it a habitual part of his active lifestyle. Let's welcome Dallas Durr.
How are you?
Good. Let's take a seat. And how are you?
Good.
Great to have you on the show. Thank you for being here. So let's go ahead and get started with a little bit of background info on you and this wonderful icy sport. So how did you start ice hockey?
Well, I was about 7 years old when I first got into the sport. I was living in New Jersey at the time, and the New Jersey Devils were the big team back then. It was about in the late 90s, early 2000s. And I just sort of fell into the sport.
Okay, that makes sense. I find that a lot of people's dreams start from, you know, early childhood and mm-hmm. such. So, furthering that on, what spiked your ambition for hockey or in your passion, really?
Well, my earliest recollection of hockey was I was young. I was around mm-hmm. 7 at the time, and I was at a friend's house, and he had NHL bed sheets, and I had no idea what it was. And I just was enthralled with these different logos and all the different teams and things like that. And so I started looking it up, and that's really how I got into hockey, all because of someone's bed sheets.
Okay, and what's your, you know, since you've been playing for a while now, I assume you're very used to being on a team and in being a part of this. What's your day-to-day routine in preparation for a game?
Well, game days, you know, you tend to build a routine, and hockey players are very superstitious, so you like to do the same thing
really?
Over and over. Yes, very, very, yes.
How so? Give me an example.
Well, whenever game days, I always have a cup of coffee on my way to the rink. I always have one. And then when I get there, I get on my workout clothes, like shorts and T-shirts. I go somewhere alone, do the same stretches over and over. And then once I'm done, I start getting my equipment on. I always do the same thing, like put my equipment on the same way, start down, lower body, and work my way up. And it's the same thing every time. I always tend to get ready way before everyone else. So it's you definitely build a routine. Superstition is a big part of hockey.
So you're telling me every single game you do the exact same thing?
Yep.
Yeah. That's fascinating. I'm myself a very superstitious person. I find that fascinating. So tell me about, okay, since we're on the topic of superstition, just makes sense. What's your worst hockey experience?
Well, you know, you have, hockey's a game of mistakes, is what people say. And, you know, you make mistakes every game. And for hockey, you really have to have a short-term memory, because if you linger on the bad things, the rest of the game's going to be bad. So if you have, if you make a mistake or something like that, you really got to put it behind you, get it out of your head, and just focus on the next shift, because hockey's a second-to-second thing. So you really got to have a short-term memory when it comes to bad things. But as for one specific, I've never broken any bones, but one bone I did kind of break was my orbital bone. I'd gotten into a fight, and he landed a good one, and it fractured the orbital, and my eye kind of sunk. But,
oh my God!
But it's all better now. You know, don't worry. Everything's better now.
Do we have pictures
I can see.
Of that?
I can see now.
All right, that's good. That's good. So now, on a more positive note, how does being part of a team help you in being active? And after that, what is your best memory of hockey?
Well, I think any team sport is great. You know, it's a great way to build relationships with people. Playing hockey, when I was younger, I was on the ice 6 days a week, and I was with my teammates more than I was with my family sometimes. And you build a real strong bond with them, and you make relationships that'll last a lifetime, and I still keep in touch with most of the kids I've played hockey with over the years.
Okay, so what's your best memory of hockey?
There's too many to pick just one, but if I had to pick one, it was my junior team, my last year juniors. We made it all the way to the finals and the playoffs and won, and ended up going to nationals in Las Vegas, which was a real experience. Yeah, it was awesome. I wasn't 21 at the time, and I was in Vegas, but it was still fun. it was still a good time.
Yeah. So I take it, being part of this team, you've mentioned it's like a family. Mm-hmm. It really helps you push forward with your goals. I mean, not just with, say, hockey per se, even though that's really where you connect, but how does that help you individually?
Well, your teammates are always there to push you, and you're there to push them. You always want to become the best, want to be better at everything you do, and that's why your teammates and coaches are there. They're there to help you really get better at what you want and build you for like just a stronger character overall. And if it wasn't for hockey, I don't think I'd be where I'm at right now, just with morals and things like that. It really helps you be the person you want to be.
Yeah. So how have you adapted to the changes over time of, not playing hockey, now that that's such a big part of your life? How would you compare, could you ever stop playing?
I don't think I could ever stop. I tried. I took a little bit of time off when I was done with juniors, and it just something in me wanted to get back into it. And so I got back into hockey, and even when I'm not playing hockey physically, I spend a lot of time watching it, and it takes up a lot of my time. So I really don't know what I'd be doing if it wasn't for hockey.
Yeah, you get antsy if you don't play,
you know. You gotta get back out there and get on the ice. It's just something about stepping on the ice again. It just takes everything away.
I love that. I love that. I love listening to every athlete who comes here and who talks to me about that passion, that feeling, that love. That, you can't live without it.
Whether it's the football stadium or baseball stadium or whatever you do, as soon as you step out there, really everything else just sort of disappears. Yeah, you're focused, laser focused.
Yeah. So this is sort of our final question. It's a signature question we like to ask everyone that comes on the show. Say, for example, if somebody's watching right now who's very interested in the sport or just generally being active or being part of a team or anything, what would you recommend they do to take that first step into making that choice of a more active lifestyle?
Well, for hockey, for sure, just go out and skate. Just even if you can't, it's fun. It's a lot of fun just going out and skating. A lot of places around here offer public skating where you can just go rent a pair of skates if you don't own your own and just get out there and see how it feels, And it's real fun. You'll end up liking it most likely, and, it's something you're going to want to continue to do.
Yeah, for sure. Now, please tell us, I'm so very intrigued. I definitely want to go to a hockey game. So When are the next upcoming 2018 games that maybe we could go to?
Yeah, we have a bunch in 2018. You know, we had the first half of the season was good, and now going into 2018, we still have a bunch of games, and you can follow us on MTSU Ice Hockey on Facebook, on Instagram, and follow up, keep up to date with all the games. We still have a few in 2018, so be sure to come out to one.
I will make sure to do that, and all of you do that too. So, as a final show of gratitude, our team here at HealthFit would like to present you with this gift.
Thank you. Let's see what we got, man.
Thank you for being here.
It's wrapped real well.
Yes, it is. We do a good job of wrapping.
Ooh, got a coffee mug for my
coffee. Can we see that?
Games.
Please show us. Oh my gosh, that is so great. Now you can drink your coffee from this mug for your next game as part of your routine. You know, hopefully HealthFit will bring you a lot of luck on your next game.
I hope so.
Yes, for sure. And so here we are at the end of our first season. You know, thank you so much for tuning in, not only today, but this entire time. Be on the lookout for season 2 coming up in the spring of 2018. And don't forget to follow us on Facebook at MT10 HealthFit for more information. I'm Joanna, and we are HealthFit. Happy holidays, and I'll see you next year. Stay active, MTSU.